The active object I chose was the string, because the string is the one that you can type words in. So I added a string at the top here, ugly furniture organization. That was just from the little preview they gave us in the book before we started. Presents the UFO game. I came up with a title for my game. You can call it whatever you want to call it. Then I dragged from over here. Remember, we can drag stuff to other screens. So I just dragged my little UFO over here, and then I changed the size. I made it bigger because it was too small on my opening screen. I wanted the player character to be bigger. Okay. I put the instructions on there. How you play? Well, you use the arrow keys, right? You press the space bar. You try to shoot the meteors. That's what your goal is. So I put that there. I had the play and quit buttons. I added a color in the text box. I made the words on the buttons bold so they were easier to read. Okay, and then if you look at my winter frame, I chose a different background. These are all from the library right down here. You have local library. You can also upload a picture that you find online, right? If you just look for outer space pictures, you'll get tons of stuff that you could use in this game. I chose this one from the group in the library just because I saw the little round dots and they reminded me of the photons. You guys are way more creative than me. And then I pulled the meteors out here. I added the little spaceship again. I just put a little ending message. I added the high score object, and then I put player scores above it because it doesn't really have a title. Anyway, and then there's my buttons for replay and end game. Okay. Not too hard. Then I just went in here and I just made sure the buttons worked. It took me to whatever frame they needed to go to, right? That wasn't too hard. Just is the button clicked. I did on the game frame. I went ahead and played my game. And because I copied and pasted like tons of meteors in there, my high score that I could get was 175. So I just added a little coding here. If the score gets to 175, then go to the next frame, right? Because it ended the game. There were no more meteors to shoot. Okay, I'll end up deleting that line of code after we do lesson 14, because we're gonna have a game and the little UFO is gonna go all up and down and all around. He's gonna be able to go all over the place, right? And go get, and there'll be meteors spawning, right? So more meteors will be made as you're playing the game, and you're gonna have all sorts of cool features that you added. But if you want your game to work now, to do that. So if you get all that finished, right? Just raise your hand. I just want to tell you your game working, right? So we can make sure that we fix any little tiny things that we need to fix, because we want it to be just right before we start lesson 14, right? We have to make this part work before we continue. Okay, and now, you know, you don't have to do sounds, you don't have to do any of that stuff right now. I just want to make a little working game where the meteors explode. And I'll play it so you can see it work if you want to watch it go. Okay. I see four colors already.
Everyone's.